Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. I welcome all my English language viewers to this video. Now remember, from January to June, I have covered all the best current affairs in English in my series which is called 1000 Best Current Affairs. It has already been completed in 5 parts in both Hindi and English. So the best 200 questions from every month have been already covered in this series. However, there were demands from students that they would prefer 200 best videos for July, especially from RBI grade B and other students. So okay, I'm bringing this series separately also. So this is part 1 of the 200 best MCQ from the month of July. In this, I will cover around 120 MCQs from 1st to 15th of July. So let's start the video. If you have not downloaded our app, this is our app which has been downloaded by almost 1 lakh students in 5 to 6 days of the launch. It is called Pocket News and it is free of cost. It is available on Android. We are working round the clock to make it available on iOS also very soon. You will get the current affair updates in both Hindi and English. There is a language option and you can study in the language that you desire. Recently launched Prithvi 2 missile. It has a strike range of what? So Prithvi range, it is a missile that was, it's basically capable of, it's a nuclear capable missile, right? And it was launched from Chandipur. And you know that Chandipur is in Odisha. It's a very common, missile launching facility. So its strike range is 350 km. Prithvi 2 strike range is 350 km. The central government has given states and the union territories a deadline for implementing the One Nation, One Ration Card system by which year? Now pay attention, it is One Nation, One Ration Card and not One Nation, One Card. Okay, I hope you know the difference. So One Nation, One Ration Card should be implemented by all the states in India by 30th of June 2020 and therefore the government will start implementing it from 1st of July 2020. The concerned ministry here in this case is the PDS ministry, Public Distribution System, the Food and Consumer Affairs, all that ministry headed by Ram Vilas Paswan. India and which country they have set a target that their bilateral trade should be at least $50 billion by 2025. Which country it is? It is our distant neighbor Indonesia. Now Indonesia's capital is Jakarta, and Jakarta and Palembang cities, they hosted the Asian Games in 2018. Also remember, with Indonesia we do a military exercise which is called Samudra Shakti. Now please don't confuse Samudra Shakti with Harimau Shakti. Harimau Shakti we do with Malaysia. And also don't confuse it with Mitra Shakti. Mitra Shakti we do with Sri Lanka. Indonesia's new president is Joko Widodo. He has been re-elected as the president of Indonesia. And the capital Jakarta is also the headquarter for ASEAN, which has 10 countries. Who has been appointed as the new managing director of the National Housing Bank? National Housing Bank was in news because the Reserve Bank of India, they divested their complete stake from NHB. So therefore, NHB, in which Reserve Bank of India used to have a stake, is now completely owned by the government of India. And same goes for NABARD also. RBI sold its stake in both NHB and NABARD to the government of India. So now NHB and NABARD, they are completely owned by the government of India. The new managing director for NHB is Sharda Kumar Hota, Mr. S.K. Hota. Which state has recorded the highest number of cases and deaths in swine flu? Swine flu is caused by what you call as H1N1 strain of SIV, which is swine influenza virus. The strain is H1N1. This is also important. Rajasthan recorded the maximum number of cases and deaths. More than 5,000 cases and more than 200 deaths in Rajasthan because of swine flu. Also remember, India's new health minister is Dr. Harshvardhan. His constituency is Chandni Chowk in Delhi. And India's minister for, he is the minister for health and family welfare. And India's minister for women and child development now is Smriti Irani. She is also the textile minister. Her Lok Sabha constituency is Amethi. Google has announced a new undersea internet cable called Equiano. It will connect which two continents? Now in the diagram, see, in the color yellow, you can see Africa. And this is Europe, right? This is the Mediterranean Sea. And this is Spain, this is Portugal, and you can see here that it is connecting Portugal with South Africa. And this narrow passage, so let's say this is Europe and let's say this is Africa. This is a narrow passage that divides the two. This is called Strait of Gibraltar. Strait of Gibraltar, so basically this end is Spain and this end is Morocco. So it divides Spain with Morocco, or if you would look at the larger picture, it divides Europe with Africa. And there is an underwater internet cable that will connect. So basically this underwater internet cable project is called Equiano. It will connect Africa and Europe. So the answer is first, Africa and Europe. Now Google recently launched two platforms. One is the gaming platform, which is called Stadia. And the other one is a multi-cloud platform called Anthos. Okay, Anthos and Stadia are the platforms which are launched by Google. Airtel has shut down its services on 3G network in which city? So Airtel has become the first telecom company in India which has started shutting down or phasing out 3G. The first city where they shut down 3G is Kolkata. Kolkata. What is the rank of India in terms of money parked in the Swiss bank? Swiss banks are famous, rather infamous sometimes for the money that has been stashed, the illegal money. But India's rank is 74. The maximum black money, or you know, common money, not necessary that every money parked in the Swiss bank is black money. So the country that is number one is UK. UK has the maximum money parked in the Swiss bank. And number two is America. India is at a 74th position. India will acquire, you know, anti-tank missiles called Strum Ataka from which country? Strum Ataka will India will buy from Russia. The deal is around 200 crore. India will also buy anti-missile defense system, which is S-400. S-400. India and Turkey, two countries are buying it from Russia. There is a Russian defense manufacturer called Almaz Ante. This is one of the biggest defense manufacturers in the world. It ranks in top 10 in the world. It is the biggest defense manufacturing company in India. It manufactures weapons and, you know, missiles and all of these. Almaz Ante. Who has taken over as the managing director and chief executive officer of Indian Overseas Bank? The tagline of Indian Overseas Bank is good people to grow with. So Mr. Karnam Shekhar is the new managing director and CEO of Indian Overseas Bank. Can you tell me where is the headquarter in which city of Indian Overseas Bank? Write down in comments. When do we celebrate the National Doctors' Day? It's very easy to remember. National Doctors' Day is on 1st of July. And why? Because it is the birthday of Dr. B.C. Roy, Dr. Bidhan Chandra Roy, who is said to be one of the greatest doctors ever born. He was born on 1st of July 1882. So that is why his birthday we celebrate, you know, as National Doctors' Day. In fact, he died also on 1st of July, coincidentally. And what was the theme this year? The theme was very important one, zero tolerance to violence against doctors. Zero tolerance to violence against doctors, because we have seen in the recent times that there has been a lot of violence against the doctors. Which state has launched a very ambitious project? They will plant 330 million trees in just next 2 months. It is a very ambitious project undertaken by Maharashtra. Maharashtra. And they will take the help of Japan. In fact, they will use the Miyawaki pattern of Japan. There is a Japanese tree growing pattern called Miyawaki. They will take the help. Name the Indo-Tibetan Border Police Force DIG, who has become the first civil servant and IPS officer also to scale Seven Summits Challenge. Seven Summits is basically the highest peak of every continent, like Mount Aconcagua, Mount Elbrus, Mount Kilimanjaro, and you know, Vincent Massif and Everest, all of the seven tallest peaks. Recently, it has been done by Aparna Kumar. Recently, it has also been done by a Pakistani. His name is Mirza Ali. Mirza Ali became the first Pakistan mountaineer to climb all the seven summits. And the youngest to do so is also from India. His name is Satyarup Siddhant. Satyarup Siddhant, he is from West Bengal. University Grants Commission, they have approved which scheme to boost the research projects in India? This scheme is called STRIDE. STRIDE. And no one will ask you the full form of it, but in case you want to know, it is it's a big full form. I'll not tell it right now. Remember one more thing, that this is more important, that there are two schemes started by the Ministry of HRD to boost the research in India. One is called Shreyas, S-H-R-E-Y-A-S, and the second one is STARS, S-T-A-R-S. And their grand project, the vision, it is called EQUIP. In the next 3 years, the Ministry of HRD will take the steps under Mission EQUIP, EQUIP, to basically improve the status of education in India. STRIDE full form is Scheme for Transdisciplinary Research for India's Developing Economy, but it's not very important. Remember, the HRD Minister of India has changed. Now it is Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank is the HRD Minister of India. His constituency is Haridwar. Which country has started commercial hunting of whales? Commercial hunting of whales is called whaling. And this country withdrew also from the International Whaling Commission in December 2018. It is Japan. India does military exercise with Japan called Shin Yuyu Maitri. Please don't confuse Shin Yuyu Maitri with Maitri. If I write only Maitri, then India does this military exercise with Thailand. Maitri. But Shin Yuyu Maitri with Japan. Then there is one more called Dharma Guardian, and one more along with America, which is called Malabar. In fact, there is a Coast Guard exercise between India and Japan, which is called Sahyog Kaijin. A new age has started in Japan called Reiwa, where Emperor Naruhito has taken over. Also remember the famous places in Japan like Lake Kawaguchi. Lake Kawaguchi is where the Shinzo Abe, the head of state of Japan, invited PM Modi. Which state has recently started Dastak campaign? Dastak campaign is basically to fight Japanese encephalitis. It has been done in UP, because every year we see in areas like Gorakhpur and other eastern UP, lot of children, they die from Japanese encephalitis. Prime Minister Modi, he constituted a high power committee of chief ministers for the transformation of agriculture and raising the farmers' income. Who will head this committee? This committee will be headed by Devendra Fadnavis. Remember, it is a committee which has many chief ministers. So there are two targets of the government, which is to double the farmers' income by 2022. And the second and the more important one is, by 2022, India should have agriculture exports worth $60 billion. Okay, India's target is to have agriculture exports worth $60 billion by 2022. The Minister for Agriculture and Rural Development is Narendra Singh Tomar. His constituency is Morena, which is in Madhya Pradesh. In which country recently Mahatma Gandhi IT and Biotech Park was inaugurated? It was inaugurated in Ivory Coast. There is a very famous player also from Ivory Coast called Didier Drogba. Now he is retired, but in his days he was one of the best footballers in the world. Didier Drogba. N.S. Vishwanathan has been reappointed as a deputy governor of the RBI. How many deputy governors are there in the Reserve Bank of India? So there is one governor. Right now it is Shaktikant Das. And he is assisted by four deputy governors. Now, Viral Acharya was a deputy governor. He has resigned. So right now, we have only three. Who are the three? So one is, of course, N.S. Vishwanathan. Then we have B.P. Kanungo. And then we have Mr. M.K. Jain. These are the three deputy governors in the RBI right now. RBI was in news. It opened its 22nd Ombudsman office in India and 3rd Ombudsman office in Delhi. Delhi is the only city to have not one, not two, but three Ombudsman offices. So, the answer is 1 year. He has been made deputy governor for only 1 year. Who has been appointed as the chairman of Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited? It is Mr. P.K. Purwar. It is the only government-owned telecom company in India, right? Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, and their brand ambassador is Maricom. And BSNL is the only company which has got the permission to provide internet in the commercial aircrafts in India now. Also remember, the telecom minister, Ravi Shankar Prasad, is the telecom minister of India. He is also the law minister. He is also the, you know, he has other portfolios also. Law and information technology, electronics. Tamil Yoman or Tamil Maravan is a kind of what? It's a butterfly. And why was it in news? Because Tamil Yoman has been declared as the state butterfly of Tamil Nadu. State butterfly of Tamil Nadu. 21st Commonwealth Table Tennis Championship. It will be hosted by which country? It will be hosted in India. Which state? Odisha. Where in Odisha? It will be hosted in Cuttack. Okay, in the Jawaharlal Nehru Indoor Stadium in Cuttack. Who has been appointed as the chairman of BHEL, Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited? BHEL, Mr. Atul Sobti was the chairman, but now it has changed. New chairman of BHEL is Nalin Shingal. BHEL is a Maharatan company. There are 8 Maharatan companies in India. The joint air exercise called Garud. Garud is also name of a bird. So therefore, it is an Indian Air Force exercise. India and which country they conduct Garud? Garud and Varun, they both are the exercise between India and France. The difference is that Garud is an Air Force exercise Varuna is an Indian naval exercise. And France was also in news because it has put 3% tax on, that is the GAFA tax, Google, Amazon, Facebook, and Apple. So 3% tax it has put on the first three of the four, that is Google, Amazon, and Facebook. Now, according to the latest survey in India, the periodic labor force survey by NSSO, National Sample Survey Organization, which state has the highest unemployment rate? The state that has highest unemployment rate in India is Nagaland. Very surprising. Nagaland has 21.4% and the second worst is Goa. If I talk about the lowest unemployment rate, then Meghalaya. Meghalaya is the best in terms of employment. It has the lowest unemployment rate, only 1.5%. And second best is Chhattisgarh. The Ministry of Ayush and the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, they have signed an agreement for which project? This project is called the GRID project and it is basically for the digitization of the Ayush Ministry. Ayush Minister is Shripad Yesso Nayak. His constituency is North Goa. And the Yoga Day was celebrated on 21st of June with two themes, not one but two. So according to United Nations, the theme was Yoga and Climate Action and the Indian government gave a theme called Yoga for Heart. And the main event took place in Ranchi, capital of Jharkhand. NASA has selected which Indian scientist for their Panch mission. Panch mission is basically to study sun more closely, to study the corona and the heliosphere, take photographs of sun. So Dipankar Banerjee has been appointed as the co-investigator. NASA has another mission for sun, which is called the Solar Parker Probe, named after Dr. Eugene Parker. And India also has a mission for studying the sun, which is called Aditya L1. And remember, Chandrayaan 2, it could not take off because of some technical fault, but Chandrayaan 2 mission director is Ritu Karidhal. Don't forget this name, Ritu Karidhal, she is the mission director for Chandrayaan 2. Which city has installed the world's largest solar plant? The capacity is 1,177 megawatt. It is Abu Dhabi, capital of United Arab Emirates. And in the Abu Dhabi Book Festival, which will take place in 2019, India is the guest country. Which Indian boxer has won the WBC Asia Silver Welterweight Championship? He is from India and his name is Vaibhav Yadav. Vaibhav Yadav. Also remember recently that the Sports Journalist Federation of India awards were given out. Sports Journalist Federation of India awards. The Lifetime Achievement Award was given to Prakash Padukone. He was a great badminton player, father of Deepika Padukone. Sports Person of the Year Award was given to two sportsmen. Pankaj Advani and Bajrang Punia, Pankaj Advani being from billiards and snooker and Bajrang Punia wrestler. Emerging Talent of the Year was Saurabh Chaudhary for shooting. He is from Meerut. And Team of the Year was Vidarbha cricket team because they won back-to-back Ranji Trophy. Ursula von der Leyen, she has become the leader of the European Union Commission. She is from which country? She is from Germany. The capital of Germany is Berlin. There is also a river in Germany called Rhine, R-H-I-N-E, Rhine River. Which airport in India has recently started face recognition system? The first airport to do so was the Camp Gowda in Bengaluru. And now it has been recently started in Rajiv Gandhi International Airport also, which is in Hyderabad. Which Bollywood celebrity is among the 842 new members invited by the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Science, which we call as Oscars? So three Indians have been invited to this list. Anupam Kher, Zoe Akhtar and Anurag Kashyap. So the answer is all of the above. Anurag Kashyap is a director. Zoe Akhtar is also a director. She is daughter of Javed Akhtar. And recently there was a movie of her called Gully Boy. And Anupam Kher has written his autobiography recently. What is the name? It is called Lessons Life Taught Me Unknowingly. Lessons Life Taught Me Unknowingly. Which country has won the IBSF Snooker World Team Cup 2019 in the men's team event? IBSF Snooker World Team Cup was won by Pakistan. They defeated India by a score of 3-1. And this event took place in Qatar, which will host the FIFA World Cup 2022 football. The Reserve Bank of India has constituted a committee or a working group. The purpose of this working group will be that for the core investment companies in India, you need to review the regulatory and supervisory framework. So, who is the chairman of this committee? The chairman of this committee is Tapan Ray. There is another committee called Suresh Mathur Committee that is to basically increase the micro insurance framework in India. And then there is another Nilekani Committee which is essentially regarding the digital payments in India, how we can improve the digital payments in India. Reliance Jio, they have launched a digital literacy campaign called Digital Udaan in partnership with which company? Digital Udaan has been launched by Reliance Jio in partnership with Facebook. Facebook is starting its cryptocurrency called Libra and Global Coin. Libra is imminent very soon, and Global Coin will be in 2020. And Facebook will also launch a satellite called Athena to provide broadband internet to the entire world. And the same project for Amazon is called Project Kuiper. So Project Kuiper is by Amazon, and Athena is a satellite of Facebook. Who will become the next president of the European Central Bank? She is the former IMF Director General. She is Christine Lagarde. Remember, she has resigned from the top position in IMF. In IMF, the chief economist is Geeta Gopinath. David Malpass is the president of World Bank. So Christine Lagarde will be the new president of European Central Bank. She has quit IMF. She is from France. In which Indian city International Sunflower Seed and Oil Conference will take place? It will take place in the end of July, and it will take place in Mumbai. Who has been appointed as the director of IBPS, the Institute of Banking Personnel Selection, which conducts all the exams like PO, clerk, etc.? His name is B. Haridish Kumar. B. Haridish Kumar. Which state has achieved the first rank in the Niti Aayog index called Agricultural Marketing and Farmer Friendly Reforms Index, which basically shows the agriculture transformation in a state? So the best performing state in agriculture is Maharashtra, and second is Gujarat. The Economic Survey has projected India's GDP to grow at what percent in 2019-20? According to Economic Survey, we will grow at a healthy 7% in the current financial year. The Chief Economic Advisor of India is Krishnamurti Subramaniam. There is a volcano called Mount Stromboli. It erupted recently. Now, it is located in which country? Mount Stromboli, then there is Mount Vesuvius, and then there is Mount Etna. All are in Italy, and all the three are active. Although Mount Vesuvius is less active compared to the other two, Mount Etna and Mount Stromboli erupted recently. Government of India has signed a memorandum of understanding with which IT company to use artificial intelligence in agriculture? Artificial intelligence in agriculture, the framework will be provided by IBM. IBM recently acquired a company called Red Hat for $34 billion, one of the biggest deals in the history. And IBM's artificial intelligence platform is called Watson. Which state has launched the Vali Decree Yojana? Vali Decree Yojana has a multifaceted approach. It will bring down the child marriages, improve the girl child birth rate, improve the sex ratio, socioeconomic status of women. All of these things will be the areas of focus for Vali Decree Yojana in Gujarat. Gujarat also has another scheme for the girls, which is called Purna scheme, which is to reduce the anemia in the adolescent girls. Which state government has launched a portal called Meri Fasal Mera Byora, which means My Crop, My Account, My Account of the Crops? Meri Fasal Mera Byora is started by the government of Haryana. Government of Haryana. It is for the farmers to directly avail the crop related benefits online. Which state government? Okay, this we have done. Which bank has acquired 9.47% stake in Everready Batteries? It is Yes Bank. Yes Bank has acquired almost 9.5% in Everready. Indian rupee will now be an accepted currency at all the retail outlets of which airport? This airport is Dubai Airport. So at the Dubai Airport, you can now make payments in rupees. And remember, Dubai, it is a part of the UAE, United Arab Emirates. It has Dubai, Sharjah, Ras Al Khaimah, and all these places. So UAE currency is dirham. Bonalo festival was recently kicked off in which city? Bonalo is a famous festival of Hyderabad. Okay, it's a Hyderabad festival. It takes place in Shri Jagdamba temple in Hyderabad. Now there is another festival in Telangana which is the most famous. It is called Batukamma festival. In Batukamma festival, the flowers are used which are called Tangedu, and Tangedu have been declared now as a state flower by the government of Telangana. Who has been appointed as the ambassador for Jal Shakti Abhiyan? Jal Shakti Abhiyan is for water conservation in 256 districts of India where there is a scarcity of water. Started by the Ministry of Jal Shakti, headed by Gajender Singh Shekhawat. He is the Minister for Jal Shakti. His Lok Sabha constituency is Jodhpur. Amir Khan is the brand ambassador for Jal Shakti Abhiyan. Remember, it is in 256 districts of India. And the government has also promised piped water in every household of India. It is called Nal Jal Scheme, and the target is 2024. Which Indian city has made its entry into the UNESCO World Heritage Site recently? In the UNESCO World Heritage Site, Jaipur has been included. Okay, becoming the fourth city in Asia to do so. And which was the first? So first was Bhaktapur in Nepal. Bhaktapur in Nepal. Second one was Gaul in Sri Lanka. Third one was Ahmedabad in India. And fourth is Jaipur. Ahmedabad was declared a World Heritage City in 2017. And last year, the Victorian Art and Gothic Architecture in Mumbai, the Ensemble, was declared as the World Heritage Site. And this year in 2018, the Jaipur city has been declared as a World Heritage Site. So now we have the fourth city in Asia to become World Heritage Site. UNESCO also declared Rio de Janeiro, the city in Brazil, as the World Capital of Architecture for 2020. Rio hosted the Summer Olympics in 2016 and the FIFA Football World Cup in 2014. And also remember, UNESCO has declared Sharjah in 2019 as the World Book Capital and Kuala Lumpur, the capital of Malaysia, as the World Book Capital for 2020. UNESCO's Director General is Audrey Azoulay and UNESCO is headquartered in Paris. The Union Cabinet has approved the Memorandum of Understanding between India and Maldives. So, between India and Maldives, okay, there is a ship service or a ferry that will be started. It will connect which city of India to Maldives? It will connect the coastal city of Kochi in Kerala to Maldives. Maldives is the Maldives is the first country that PM Modi visited on becoming the Prime Minister for the second time. Okay, and when Prime Minister Modi became the Prime Minister in 2014 for the first time, the first country that he visited was Bhutan, but this time it is Maldives. And Maldives have given their highest civilian honor to Pradhan Mantri Modi, which is called Rule of the Nishan Izzuddin. Okay, Rule of the Nishan Izzuddin. This is the highest civilian honor given by Maldives to PM Modi. Also, PM Modi has won other awards also, like Zayed Medal by UAE or the Order of the St. Andrews the Apostle, Philip Kotler Award, and UN Champions of Earth Award, and many others. And Ibrahim Muhammad Soleh is the president of Maldives. Capital is Male. Which railway zone has commissioned the longest electrified tunnel, 6.6 kilometer, built at a total cost of 460 crore. The longest electrified tunnel in India is by South Central Railway. Remember, Secunderabad is the headquarter of South Central Railway. And the most important thing, there is a new railway zone in India called South Coast Railway. And the headquarter is Visakhapatnam. It has the divisions like Guntur, Guntakal, Vijayawada. All of this now is in South Coast Railway. And South Coast Railway has been made by separating it from the South Central Railway. So now there are 18 railway zones in India. And if they ask you that this tunnel which connect which two places, so it will connect Cherlopalli with Rapuru. Remember this also, very important. It will connect Cherlopalli with Rapuru. The Army Chief Bipin Rawat, he has released a Kargil tribute song to honor the Kargil martyrs and the war veterans. The song is sung by which person? So on 26th of July 2019, we will complete 20 years of Kargil war. It was called Operation Vijay. So Shatadru Kabir has sung the song. Shatadru Kabir. The Securities and Exchange Board of India, they will transfer what percent of their surplus from the general fund to the consolidated fund of India? So SEBI, the Securities and Exchange Board of India, chairman is Ajay Tyagi, they will contribute 75% of their surplus. They will transfer it to the government of India. Border Security Force, they have launched which operation to fortify anti-infiltration grid along the Pakistan border in Punjab and Jammu? So we have a long border with Pakistan, almost 1000 km and 4 states, Jammu, Kashmir, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat, right? So they will fortify the Pak border so that there are less infiltrations. In fact, 43% less infiltrations this year compared to last year. But of course, more can be done. And Border Security Force takes care of our border with Pakistan and Bangladesh. The operation is called Operation Sudarshan. One more operation you remember, in fact two more, one is called Operation Bandar. It was the Balakot strike that India conducted, that was called Operation Bandar. Bandar means monkey. And then there is one more, Operation Sankalp. It has been recently started by the Indian Navy in the wake of the attacks on the Indian ships in the Strait of Hormuz that connects the Persian Gulf with the Gulf of Oman. So to secure the ships in the Strait of Hormuz, Indian Navy has started Operation Sankalp. Which country has won the FIFA Women's World Cup? Women's World Cup was conducted, it was hosted by France, and United States won it. They defeated Netherlands by a score of 2-0. Netherlands' capital is Amsterdam. And the FIFA Men's World Cup was organized by Russia. It was won by France, defeating Croatia in the final by a score of 4-2. As per the data shared by the Ministry of State for Social Justice and Empowerment, which state in India has the maximum senior citizen? Senior citizen, we say when a person is more than 60 years old. The maximum senior citizen in India are in UP around 54 lakh and second highest is in Maharashtra around 11 lakh. The union government, they will set up 3 sports center of excellence in which city very soon. It will be set up in Itanagar in Arunachal Pradesh. In fact, the sports minister of India is also from Arunachal Pradesh. His name is Kiran Rijiju. Kiran Rijiju, his constituency is Arunachal West. Arunachal West. Also remember, there will be a national sports stadium for the disabled that will come up in Meghalaya. Remember that. National sports stadium for disabled will be set up in Meghalaya and National Sports University will be set up in Manipur. Revenue Secretary Ajay Bhushan Pandey has announced that the Aadhaar card can be quoted for cash transactions above what amount. Earlier, if you needed to make any transaction above 50,000 rupees, you needed to furnish your PAN number, permanent account number. But now, no need of PAN, you can use your Aadhaar number, that is equally good. One more thing, ITR, income tax return if you want to file. Both PAN and Aadhaar are now viable. Shrikhand Mahadev Yatra took place in which of the following states in the month of July? Shrikhand Mahadev Yatra took place in Kullu. Kullu is in Himachal Pradesh. Prime Minister Modi has unveiled the statue of former Prime Minister of India Lal Bahadur Shastri, who was also born on 2nd of October along with Mahatma Gandhi, at which airport? So, Lal Bahadur Shastri statue was inaugurated at the Varanasi airport. Varanasi is the Lok Sabha constituency of PM Modi. Pope Francis, he will declare which Indian nun as a saint on 13th of October for immense contribution to social service. Pope Francis, right now the Pope is from Argentina and he sits at the Vatican, St. Basilica in Vatican, Rome in Italy, and Mariam Theresia will be declared as a saint. Mariam Theresia. Which country has won the Copa America? So let me clear the confusion for you, because for those who don't follow football, this is always a confusion. This is North America. When I say North America, this is the North American continent. Clear? This is what you call the Central America and this is the South America. Okay? And then there are some islands here which we call as the Caribbean or the West Indies. Clear or not clear? Now let's first talk about South America. South America has some big countries like Brazil, Argentina, Peru, Bolivia, all of these countries. Venezuela and Uruguay, Paraguay, all of these are in South America. The team that wins the South America continent is the Copa America. So Copa America is played by the South American countries only, right? So if anybody wins the Copa America, then he is said to be the South American champion. That is Brazil. Brazil, they defeated Peru in the final by a score of 3-1. So Brazil are the champions of South America. But a lot of part of America is still left. We have the West Indies. Okay. We have teams like Jamaica and, Barbados and all of these. And this is Central America, which has countries like El Salvador and Panama and all these. And then we have the North America, which has 3 countries. Canada, middle one is the USA, United States of America, and the third one is the Mexico. So this entire area, that is the North America, Central America, and the West Indies, they play football together in a tournament that is called the CONCACAF Cup. And that was won by Mexico. Mexico defeated America in the final. So Mexico are the champions of this region and Brazil are the champions of this region. Now this is with respect to the country football. But the football is also played at the club level. So Europa League was won by Chelsea. And Champions League, which is the biggest competition at the club level, right? Champions League was won by Liverpool. So I hope the confusion is clear. You will not forget it. Which political leader recently shared a blog on water conservation? The title of the blog was A Daughter, A Tree and A Teacher. This blog was shared by Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi. Which indigenous aircraft carrier will be delivered to the Indian Navy in 2021 for advanced trial? See, Indian Navy has only one aircraft carrier. It is called INS Vikramaditya. INS Vikramaditya, it is the only aircraft carrier that we have. We need more, of course. So now we are making 2. One is ready, INS Vikrant. So answer is INS Vikrant. The best part is it is self-made, made in India, indigenous. And the third one, we are building with the help of UK. See, Vikramaditya, we purchased from Russia. So Vikramaditya was made in Russia and then shipped to India. UK is helping us now to make another aircraft carrier, which is called INS Vishal. INS Vishal. Also remember, the sovereign gold bond scheme has started. If you want to invest in gold, then you can do so by sovereign gold bond scheme. The question that they ask in exam from the sovereign gold bond scheme is that, what is the minimum investment, what is the maximum? So if you are an individual, then, or a Hindu undivided family, any of the two, then you can invest minimum 1 gram and maximum 4 kg in the sovereign gold bond. Minimum is 1 gram and maximum is 4 kg. If you are a trust, minimum remains 1 gram, but maximum is increased from 4 kg to 20 kg. Clear? So for trust, it is 20 kg. For individual, the maximum is 4 kg. For Hindu undivided family, also it is 4 kg. Defense Research Development Organization, they have successfully tested NAG missile. It is what type of missile? So NAG is an anti-tank guided missile. Anti-tank guided missile. Now NAG can also be launched from helicopter. That version is called Helina. Helina. In fact, it can be launched from shoulder also. That variant which can be launched from shoulder, it is called man-portable anti-tank guided missile. And it weighs only 14.5 kg. So that anybody can just launch it from shoulder. DRDO chairman is Mr. G. Satish Reddy. Board of Control for Cricket in India, BCCI, has appointed which person as the head of cricket at the National Cricket Academy? He is Rahul Dravid, the Wall. He was also declared in the ICC Hall of Fame in 2018. Indian Army will buy Excalibur guided, very powerful, long-range artillery ammunition. The strike range is up to 50 km away from which country? We will buy Excalibur guided ammunition from United States of America. We have already bought a lot of helicopters recently from America, like the Chinook helicopter, which is used for transportation, or the Boeing made Apache helicopter, which is used for attack, right? Chinook, Apache, and Romeo, which is the Seahawk, again, attack helicopter, again by America. And we have recently bought Kamov helicopter from Russia and S-400 defense system also from Russia. So the answer is America. We are also buying something from Israel, by the way. One is the Barak 8 missile, which is a joint venture of Israel and India. Barak 8 missile. And also the LR anti-tank spike missile. Okay, LR spike missile that we will buy from Israel. Who has become the second fastest Indian to take 100 wickets in one-day matches? The highest, what is the meaning of the word fastest? Fastest means in the least number of matches. So answer is second fastest they are asking. So answer is Jasprit Bumrah. And fastest remains Mohammad Shami. If I talk about India, the all-time world record holder is Rashid Khan of Afghanistan. He took 100 wickets in only 44 matches, in one day matches. So he's the world record holder. Jasprit Bumrah, I think, took some 56 matches, 57, and Mohammad Shami took 56 matches. Clear? And Jasprit Bumrah has taken 18 wickets in the World Cup. So he is the highest wicket taker from India in the World Cup. Oh, of course, overall highest is Mitchell Starc from Australia. He took 27 wickets. Asia's first Six Sigma Institute of Mountain Medicine and High Altitude Rescue will be established in which state? It is not just India's, but Asia's first Six Sigma Institute of Mountain Medicine. It will come up in Uttarakhand. Where in Uttarakhand? In Rudraprayag. Rudraprayag. Also in Uttarakhand, there is a place called Pithoragarh. If you remember, the Lipu Lake Pass that connects the Kailash Mansarovar Yatra goes through Pithoragarh only. So right at the China border. So Pithoragarh, the second tulip garden of India, was recently established at Pithoragarh. First, of course, is in Jammu and Kashmir. And then we have a scheme called Aanchal Amrit Yojana, Mukhya Mantri Aanchal Amrit Yojana, where free milk will be provided to the sons and daughters of those who are working in the Anganwadi in Uttarakhand. And Uttarakhand also planted 10,000 Rudraksh trees on the bank of the Ganga River. Recently, India has completed 50 years of partnership with which organization? And to commemorate that occasion, a coffee book was launched by Narendra Singh Tomar, the Minister for Agriculture and Rural Development. India has completed 50 years of partnership with United Nations World Food Programme, headquartered in Rome, which is the capital of Italy. In Rome, you will also find the headquarters of the Food and Agriculture Organization. Italian Prime Minister is Giuseppe Conte. Giuseppe Conte. Which country has won the CONCACAF Gold Cup? So I told you CONCACAF Gold Cup is by North America plus Central America plus the West Indies. It is Mexico. They defeated America in the final. Reserve Bank of India, they have finalized a 3-year roadmap called what? For improving regulation and supervision of the central bank. Basically, they want to upgrade their regulatory and supervisory framework for all the banks in India, and this project is called Utkarsh 2022, because it is envisaged for 3 years. Also remember, there was a project called Sparrow. Project Sparrow was started by the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs for appraising the officers of the CBIC. Operation Milap, it is an initiative of which police? Operation Milap is an initiative of Delhi police. This is basically to rescue those children who have run away from home to make them meet their parents once again, or who have been abducted. Just rescue them and get them to meet their parents again. Now, Delhi police is the first police in India that has made digital all the malkhanas. Malkhanas are the place where the seized weapons are kept. India's first elephant rehabilitation center. It will come up in which of the following villages of Kerala? It will come up in Kuttur. Kuttur will have the first elephant rehabilitation center of India. Now remember, the first elephant hospital of India was opened in Mathura. Mathura is in UP, and it was opened by an NGO which is called Wildlife SOS. The first model village built with the Indian help in Sri Lanka is called Rani Dugama. Okay, so the question is that only, that the first model village with assistance from India, and the village is called Rani Dugama, it has been inaugurated in which country? So India has made a model village in Sri Lanka which is called Rani Dugama. So the answer is Sri Lanka. Maithripala Sirisena is the president and Ranil Wickremesinghe is the prime minister of Sri Lanka. Countries of which continent? 15 countries of which continent they have adopted ECHO as a currency? It is the currency of Africa. So the 15 African countries, they now use ECHO. MS Dhoni, he is only the second Indian to play 350 one-day matches for India. Who was the first? First one was Sachin Tendulkar. Who has won the women's 100-meter sprint at the Universiad, the World University Games in Naples, Italy? So 100 meter sprint was won by Duti Chand, and she is from Odisha. Now remember, Hima Das, she takes part in 200 meter and 400 meter races, mostly 200 meter. She is from Assam and is called Dhing Express. As per the information produced in the Lok Sabha by the Ministry of Home Affairs headed by Amit Shah, he is Lok Sabha constituency is Gandhinagar, capital of Gujarat. The net infiltration in Jammu Kashmir has been reduced by what percent in the last 1 year? The infiltration across the border has been reduced by 43% in 1 year. Jammu Kashmir, the governor is Satyapal Malik. Which state will soon produce its own seeds under the brand name called Sahabij? Sahabij will be produced by the government of Madhya Pradesh. And Madhya Pradesh government started a scheme also called Yuva Swabhiman Yojana for the unemployed youth. And recently Madhya Pradesh inaugurated their 52nd district, which is called Nevadi. Kamal Nath is the chief minister. Who was declared as the men's footballer of the year by the All India Football Federation headed by Praful Patel? Praful Patel is the chairman of All India Football Federation. Men's best player is Sunil Chhatri and women's best player is Asha Lata Devi. Which is going to be the first train to be operated by private players in India? The private company. First train is the Delhi-Lucknow Tejas Express. Now remember, the first railway station in India to be operated by a private company is Habibganj. Habibganj is in Bhopal, MP. World Health Organization has declared which country as measles-free? Measles-free country now is Sri Lanka. Now remember, two countries were recently declared malaria-free. One is Algeria and one is Argentina. World Health Organization Director General is Tedros Adhanom and he is from Ethiopia. Headquarter is in Geneva. And chief scientist in WHO is Indian Soumya Swaminathan. Who was appointed as the Director General of the Directorate General of Civil Aviation? Who is basically the DGCA? Earlier it was B.S. Buller, now it is Arun Kumar. So the answer is Arun Kumar. Now remember a few important people with respect to civil aviation. First, who is the Minister of Civil Aviation? Hardeep Singh Puri. He is also the Minister for Urban Development, that is Housing and Urban Affairs. Then who is the Chairman of Air India? Ashwani Lohani. Ashwani Lohani is the chairman of Air India. And the third one, who is the chairman of Airport Authority of India? It is Guru Prasad Mohapatra. The Northeast Frontier Railway, headquartered in Guwahati, Northeast Frontier Railway, which initiative of Northeast Frontier Railway has won the Best Innovation Award? The Best Innovation is Plan B. Plan B is basically to plant lot of bee boxes near the trains so that the elephants are kept at bay. Elephants fear the honeybees, right? If you have honeybees near the railway tracks, elephants will not get killed by the approaching train. This is called Plan B. Kharchi Puja. Kharchi Puja is a festival started where? It started in Tripura. Tripura, okay. Tripura's capital is Agartala. The Agartala airport was named after Maharaja Veer Vikram Manikya Kishore. Maharaja Veer Vikram Manikya Kishore. And the government of Tripura, they have started their own tea, which is called Tripureshwari. Tripureshwari tea. And if you see the logo of Tripureshwari tea, you will find the Neer Mahal. Neer Mahal is an iconic building where Maharaja Veer Vikram Manikya Kishore used to stay. And Neer Mahal is located in between a lake which is called Rudrasagar. Rudrasagar. So Tripura's CM is Biplab Kumar Dev of the BJP. India's first cow sanctuary, which is called Kamadhenu Gau Abhyaranya, has been established in which district of Madhya Pradesh? First of all, you need to remember that India's first cow sanctuary was built in Madhya Pradesh in Agar Malwa district. Agar Malwa. Also, Madhya Pradesh is the first state in India which is building smart cow shelters, which are called smart gaushalas in India. What is the name of the human atlas that has been formed by the Department of Biotech? It is called Manav. Manav is the name of the human atlas made by the Department of Biotechnology. Railway Protection Force, they have launched which operation to crack down on the selling of the unauthorized packaged drinking water in the railway premises? There is a brand of mineral water by railways called Rail Neer. But a lot of people, they sell fake mineral water bottle, and to counter those, they started Operation Thirst. Operation Thirst. Indian Army, they will buy anti-tank spike missile from which country? Anti-tank LR spike missile will be bought from Israel. India's first Dolphin Research Institute will come up in which university? India's first Dolphin Research Center will come up in Patna University. But very important. Yes, right now it is coming up in Patna University, but it will be shifted to Bhagalpur later on. Because in Bhagalpur, we have India's only Dolphin Research Center, which is called Vikramshila. Vikramshila Dolphin Research Institute, it is in Bhagalpur. So from Patna University, later on, it will be shifted to Bhagalpur. Also remember, there is a Irrawaddy dolphin that you will find in the Chilka Lake in Odisha. It is the largest habitat of Irrawaddy dolphins in the world. And the more important question is, there is a Indus dolphin. Punjab has declared Indus dolphin as their state aquatic animal. State aquatic animal. Also remember, India's first aquatic mega food park has been opened in West Godavari district of Andhra Pradesh. The government will set up a secretary level task force under whose chairmanship to figure out how we can create a $110 billion mobile phone export market in India. We want to export the mobile phones worth $110 billion. And for that, Amitabh Kant has been made the chairman of the committee. He is the CEO of the Niti Aayog. Which thermal power plant will be shut down and replaced by a solar park? It is Rajghat Thermal Power Plant in Delhi. Rajghat. Which company has launched India's first ethanol-based motorcycle? Ethanol-based motorcycle has been made by TVS Motor. Also remember, there is a plane called AN-32. It has been certified. It can be flown from biojet fuel. AN-32 is now certified to be flown from biojet fuel. Which player won the women's single title at the Wimbledon? Wimbledon is the oldest tennis tournament in the world, and it was won by Simona Halep. She is from Romania. There are four Grand Slams. First is Australian Open, then French Open, then Wimbledon, and then US Open. US Open has not taken place so far for 2019. Australian Open has taken place. It was won by Naomi Osaka of Japan for the women's section and Novak Djokovic of Serbia for the men's section. Then we have the French Open. It was won by Rafael Nadal of Spain. Among women, it was won by Ashleigh Barty. She is the world number one player right now. She is from Australia. And now, recently concluded Wimbledon, it was won again by Novak Djokovic of Serbia. In the men's section, and women Simona Halep, who is from Romania. Novak Djokovic is from Serbia. So Novak Djokovic has won Australian Open and the Wimbledon 2019. Who has been appointed as the next managing director and chief financial officer of the World Bank? She started her career as a normal PO in a bank, and now look at her. She is the MD of the World Bank. She is Anshula Kant. The world's biggest diamond mine, called Argyll Diamond Mine, it has been shut down now. It was located where? It is located in Western Australia. Australia hosted the Commonwealth Games in 2018 in the Queensland Gold Coast. Now remember, Argyle Diamond Mine is the world's biggest diamond mine, and it was owned by a company called Rio Tinto Group. Rio Tinto Group, who has been chosen as the health ambassador of Mission Shakti, which is basically a school-based health awareness, knowledge, test and training initiative launched by Indian Council of Medical Research. Mahatma Gandhi has been made the health ambassador. Which state government has decided to celebrate 12th of July every year as Save Water Day? It is West Bengal. West Bengal will celebrate 12th of July every year as the Save Water Day. Who has been appointed as the secretary, consular, passport, visa and overseas Indian affairs in the External Affairs Ministry? He has written a book also called Q&A. And on this book, Q&A, was based the movie Slumdog Millionaire. Q&A book is written by Vikas Swarup. He's an exceptional writer and equally good diplomat. So he will head the consular, passport, visa and overseas Indian affairs. He has made the secretary. Our external affairs minister is S. Jaishankar, and his first foreign visit was to Bhutan. Remember, S. Jaishankar's first foreign visit was to Bhutan in the capacity as the external affairs minister of India. The central government has banned which pro-Khalistani group for its alleged anti-national activity? It is called Six for Justice. Six for Justice. Reebok, who is the new brand ambassador? Reebok brand ambassador new is Katrina Kaif. Phone Pay, Amir Khan, and Bharat Pay, Salman Khan. Indian scientists at the Mumbai-based Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, they have created a unique material. What is the name of that material? To boost solar panel and solve the drinking water problem in India. According to Niti Aayog, 21 Indian cities will run out of groundwater by 2020, that is the end of the next year. And according to Niti Aayog, 40% of India's population will have no access to drinking water by 2030. So, we need to solve the water crisis. They have created a material which is called black gold. Black gold. Who has won the Golden Bat award at the World Cup? Golden Bat is given to that person who scores the maximum runs. They were scored by Rohit Sharma. Man of the series, also called player of the tournament, is Kane Williamson, New Zealand captain, and player of the match. Man of the match in the final was Ben Stokes. Final was played at the Lord's Cricket Ground. So most runs, Rohit Sharma, you can see 648, and just one less run, 647, was scored by David Warner. David Warner was a close second. Shakib Al Hasan was third. And most wickets were taken by Mitchell Starc. This is a new world record. Because earlier the world record for maximum wickets in a single edition of the World Cup was by Glenn McGrath. He took 26 wickets in the 2007 World Cup. Also two bowlers, they took the hat-trick. One is Trent Boult and Mohammad Shami. They both took hat-tricks in this World Cup. Name the American computer scientist who invented computer password. He passed away recently. His name was Fernando Corbato. Fernando Corbato. Which IT company has acquired software company Red Hat for $34 billion, one of the biggest deals in the history of the world? It is IBM. Government of India has launched which initiative to improve the quality of care in the labor room and maternity operation theater? So basically, when a pregnant woman does delivery, that time she is very vulnerable. So we need to have more institutional delivery, which means hospital assisted deliveries, and midwives should also be present. So the quality in the labor room and maternity operation theater should be upgraded. This will also reduce the maternal mortality rate. This is called Project Lakshya. Almost 25 million Android devices around the world, they have been infected by which virus? It is called Agent Smith. So this was in English, the part 1 of the July Best 100 Current Affairs. If you liked and enjoyed the video, give me a thumbs up. If not, still give me a thumbs up and share the video with your friends also. I'll see you very soon in part 2. Also, we have some paid courses, which are the pen drive courses. If you want to buy, do check out our website, studyiq.com. The PDF of this video has already been shared on our website. And I'll see you very soon in part 2. Thank you so much and take care.